Abu Turab, the father of soil, is a title given to Amir al-Mu'mineen wa Mawla al-Muttaqeen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. It's a title that was beloved to Amir al-Mu'mineen. It was an epithet that was given to the commander of the faithful by the messenger of God himself. It was a description used to talk about Amir al-Mu'mineen by his enemies, seeking to distort his reputation and character assassinate him. Yet it's a description that displays his excellence and status. Indeed, at the outset, people ask the question, what is the difference in Arabic between laqab and kunya? Because Abu Turab is known as the kunya of Amir al-Mu'mineen. We are told that the kunya in Arabic is when you have a prefix ab or for example, Abu Abdullah or Ummul Banin is known as what? A kunya. A laqab is a description, it's an epithet that's given to certain individuals, normally characterizing their personality or displaying some kind of understanding of their qualities or their characteristics. The narrations tell us, how is he called Abu Turab? The narrations tell us one day he was with Ammar ibn Yasir radwanullahi ta'ala alayh. When he was with Ammar, he was resting under a tree in Ghazwat Bani Ashira, it is known, in the second year after Hijrah. Amir al-Mu'mineen was with Ammar, they slept under the tree. Prophet of Islam was looking for them. The Prophet found Ammar and Amir al-Mu'mineen. He saw that when Amir al-Mu'mineen was asleep, there was dust and soil where on his face, on his body. He started to remove the turab and said to him, Qum Aba Turab, rise, O the father of soil, yes? And then he said to him, the worst of the people of the time before us is the man who slayed the she-camel of Salih. And the worst of the people in this time is the man who will dye your beard with your blood from your head. That was whom? That was the Prophet of Allah informing whom? Amir al-Mu'mineen, that his title is Abu Turab. Question, does it have further implications? Does it mean more than the father of soil? What does Abu Turab in reality refer to? We have some narrations which requires your attention. The narrations highlight that Abu Turab is given to Amir al-Mu'mineen to demonstrate his excellence and his qualities. Listen to this narration from Ibn Abbas. He comes forward and says, the reason why Amir al-Mu'mineen was called this, لِأَنَّهُ صَاحِبُ الْأَرْضِ وَحُجَّةَ اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِهَا بَعْدَهِ, because Amir al-Mu'mineen is the man of this earth and the representative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this earth. وَبِهِ بَقَاؤُهَا وَإِلَيْهِ سُكُونُهَا. Through Ali is the continuation of life, and through Amir al-Mu'mineen is the tranquility of this earth. That's why the famous poet, who is the Christian Lebanese poet by the name of Paul al-Salama, what does he say? I said to him, tell me of a man other than Ali who was born in the house of Allah and was raised by Rasulullah like no other. Tell me of another man like Ali, who was the first to support the messenger of God, who stood with him and slept in his bed whilst his life was at risk. Tell me of another man other than Ali, who married Sayyidatu Nisa'il Alameen and the greatest female created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tell me of another man like Ali, who defended Rasulullah and Islam in Badr, in Uhud, in Khandaq and Hunayn. Tell me of another man like Ali, whom Rasulullah would say truth is with him and Ali is with the truth. Tell me of another man other than Amir al-Mu'mineen, whom Rasulullah would say Quran is with him and he is with the Quran. I said to him, tell me of another man other than Ali that stood on the shoulders of Rasulullah, was the closest to Rasulullah, was the soul of Rasulullah, as the Quran said. I said to him, tell me of another man like Ali, who defended the interpretation of the Quran, like how Rasulullah defended the tafsir of the Quran. I said to him, tell me of another man like Ali, whom the Prophet said, if you want to see Adam in his knowledge, and Nuh in his azm, determination, and Ibrahim in his hilm, as in his forbearance, and Musa in his patience, and Isa in his ascetism, look at Amir al-Muttaqeen, wa Imam al-Mu'mineen, wa Asadullah al-Ghalib, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Then Ibn Abbas says, وَلَقَدْ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَقُولْ إِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. I heard the Prophet say, on the day of judgment, وَرَأَى الْكَافِرْ مَا أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لِشِيعَةِ عَلِيًّا مِنَ الثَّوَابِ. The kafir, the disbeliever, witnesses how much Allah has given from reward towards the shi'a of Ali, وَالزُّلْفَ وَالْكَرَامَ, and the honor and dignity. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. The kafir will say, I wish I was a turabi. I wish I was one of the followers of Abu Turab. Yes? Because in Surah Al-Fajr, what do we read? Yes? يَوْمَ يَنْظُرُ الْمَرْءُ مَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَاهُ. On that day, people will see what they have offered. وَيَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. No doubt, yes? That on the day of judgment, people will be remorseful. They will be saddened when they recognize that they have not taken the opportunity to be part of the Shia of the Commander of the Faithful, isn't it? To be of those who attain the salvation. Why? Because you and I know that Amir al-Mu'mineen is Qasim al-Jannati wal-Nar, isn't it? That as far as the distinguishing factor between Jannah and Jahannam, it's Amir al-Mu'mineen. Some people have a doubt over this. Doesn't the Holy Prophet of Islam in Sahih Muslim, the narration says that the Sahaba used to say, we were able to distinguish between a mu'min and a munafiq when we looked at whether they loved Ali ibn Abi Talib or not. And that's why you recognize that being associated with Abu Turab, being associated with Amir al-Mu'mineen is a matter of honor and pride for you and I. And it is our identity that we must protect. Why? Because I remember saying to someone, I am a Shia Muslim. They said, brother, please don't cause division between Muslims. Call yourself a Muslim. You don't need to call yourself Shia. You don't need to add something towards this title. I said to him, you do not understand. He said, what do you mean? I said to him, when you travel, what do you need? He said, when I travel, where? I said, to another country. He said, I need a ticket and I need a passport and I need a visa to enter that country. That's my minimum requirements, yes? I said to him, my ticket towards Jannah is Rasulullah. My passport towards Jannah is the Quran. And my visa towards paradise is Ali ibn Abi Talib. If you do not like it, then that's, I respect it. But don't take my visa away from me.